In this section, I am going to cover the syntax that you would use when working with multiple queue lists on the EOS. Now, this is a pretty universal syntax, and it works when you are specifying a queue list, recording a queue, going to a queue, editing a queue, and it is the following syntax. If I want to specify a queue in queue list number 2, I would say queue list number first, slash, and then I can specify a queue number. So record 2/6 would record the queue to list 2, queue number 6. If I leave my command line at queue 2/ and push enter, what's going to happen is that makes queue list 2 the active list on the EOS. And I know it's an active list because my playback status display is now showing queue list 2. Now, an active queue list is where all of my command line commands will route. So if I now record a queue, the console is going to assume list number 2, and my command line indicates that I'm looking at queue list number 2 as well. Now, what will also make a queue list active is if I push go on a particular list. So I'm looking at queue list 2, but if I push go in list 1, now list 1 becomes the active queue list. So that's important to remember. And on your command line, if there is not a specification of a list, you can assume that you're working in queue list number 1. So that's something to pay attention to. There's a lot of indicators on the console that will tell you what list you're working with. If you want to get a good overview of all of your lists and their associated properties, you can double hit the Q key to get to the queue list index. And in here is where you can see a good overview of your lists. You have the list number here. You have any playback fader that it may be associated with will be shown here. You can label your queue lists. The various fader modes, whether it's a proportional or an intensity master, or whether it's an independent or an HTTP or an LTP situation. We cover that in a different section, but here is where you would be able to set that. And those commands are accessed via the soft keys. This is also the place that you would make an entire queue list and assert queue list. And if you remember using assert on a queue by queue basis, it's the similar function, except this is where you would assign that assert function to the entire list. And this is also where you would be able to see any external links that may be assigned to a particular queue list. And that is some of the syntax that you will use when you're working with multiple queue lists on the EOS.